Hello and welcome to round 19 here at Mexico. Right, let's start the race. I do apologise about yesterday's audio. I had my brother on the phone, so I couldn't really do a great deal with my audio.
Welcome along to the most popular city in North America and home now to the Mexico City Grand Prix. It's a sellout crowd as usual here at one of the shortest circuits on the Formula One calendar. So who, I wonder, will the crowd cheer on today to the top step of the podium? We're a long way above sea level here in Mexico today, which could pose some cooling issues for the cars as they make their way around this 2.6 mile lap. 17 corners with top speeds in excess of 220 miles per hour, and watch out for potential overtaking into turns 1 and 4. It's time to see how our drivers are stacking up after yesterday's exciting qualifying session. Lee lines up on pole position, and Max Verstappen lines up alongside. Looking at the rest of today's grid, we have Norris, Gasly, Charles Leclerc and Perez, Stroll, Sainz, Hamilton and Yuki Tsunoda, Ilott, Bottas, Daniel Ricciardo and Giovinazzi, Joe, Russell, Kimi Raikkonen and Giuliano Alesi, Mick Schumacher, Mazepin, Ocon. They'll be starting further back after an earlier grid penalty, and Nicholas Latifi. And with preparations almost complete, let's head down to the track.
Okay, we've already won the championship, so relax and enjoy this race.
Right. I'm going to bang on Nightwish. The album Once. Once the adverts diminish. Right, let's do that. Let's do the formation lap.
Okay, our system checks are good. We need to stay in formation and start bringing the car up to temperature, please. Get some load into the tyres and work the brakes. We want them nice and warm by the end of the lap. The rest of the grid is forming up. Be patient and watch for the lights.
Can we start the race? Yes, we can. Here we go. Here we go. Acceleration. Max has got a very good launch. Max had a fucking epic launch. Awesome wide. just slow it down. There we go, Max has a good start now. Now catching Max. Back out onto the slide. We'll have to look into that in a second. Yeah, now that was close. Right, I got dead close as Verstappen then, but I lost all my momentum going into that corner. Right. It's just... Really? Advert already? A bit. Broken down. Hold on, someone's broken down. Let's have a look. Talk who's broken down. Is it beyond? Is it further back? I can't see where's an issue. Oh, there we go. Carlos Sainz. Engine blown. I was wondering where it was. Okay, so my back tyres ain't spinning that time.
DRS is being enabled this lap. We can use DRS when you are within 1 second of the car ahead and in the DRS zone.
Here we go. That's it. Yeah, me and Verstappen have got a good lead now.
Yellow flag. Green flag.
Here we go. Max has got slipstream on me. He's got DRS. And he's catching. Just roll the car in with overtake. I came onto the slide after that curb. Right, time to take off. Mm-hmm. Now I'm pulling away. Here we go.
Check your MFD for a new strategy option. Okay, copy that.
I'm boxing lap 7 anyway. Do an undercut. Lap 7. First warning. Testing the limits. Here we go.
We're approaching the pit window. You'll be on the mediums.
One lap and I'm pitting early. Here we go. Box this lap.
Confirmed, we'll receive you at the end of this lap. We're leading our teammate by 6.3 seconds.
Okay, I want to slide to hit the curb.
Exit, exit now. Pit strategy complete. See these tyres through to the end now.
Verstappen stayed out for one extra lap. Interesting. So I'll skip this advert in a second.
We've been awarded a time penalty. It will go against our finishing time at the end of the race.
Nope.
Are you okay?
Nope.
That was a big one. Confirm you're okay, please.
That's bullshit. I hit the fucking curb. I went in too deep. Hit the fucking grass. Fuck that bullshit. There we go. Much better exit. Max should be in the pit this lap.
The gap to the car behind is 6.1 seconds.
Yeah, Max is in. Bottas is going to be in.
Max is coming in for his stop.
Here we go, 8 laps to go. And I'm on the curb again and I'm sliding. What the fucking hell is this all about? Okay, let's look at the tyres. See, the tyres are playing up. I should have no issues really with the tyres, but you never know.
Gap to teammate behind is 13.7.
I'm sure, but because I'm looking at the tyres. And now I'm lapping people.
That was the fastest lap of the race. Keep this up.
It's the fastest lap because I actually shortcutted. Form has been out the fucking way. Has been out the fucking way. Fuck me. I don't really have any issues with the tyres going into yellow. So I wonder what the issue is then with this. Maybe it's just the curbing again is just what the issue is. Strange. Let's see if this brings out a safety car. Probably not. Choose overtake, let's go.
Five laps of fuel remaining.
Overtake. Here we go. Acceleration. I will catch up to Schumacher and maybe Latifi. I'm gaining each lap. And now Schumacher's here. And Latifi's pulled ahead. I could be mistaken, it could be whoever it is, but I think it might be Latifi. Schumacher gets out the way, just about. It's going to be a penalty.
We need to slow down before hitting the corners. We don't want to get a penalty.
Oh no, it's an Alpine. Really? Jeez. Wow.
Great work. That's a new fastest lap of the race.
No, it is Latifi. I thought the Williams looked like a bloody Alpine. What's happened to Latifi? He died at the back of me, did he? No, he died at the back of me, surely. Yeah, he does, he taps me. can't say enough front wing damage, but that was just fucking stupid. I don't even feel it or anything.
We have 2 laps of fuel remaining.
Oh, if only I could catch up to these cars here. If I had like 3 or 4 extra laps. Maybe, just maybe, I could have done it. Back, I want to slide. Bloody hell.
This is your final lap of the race.
Could be tyre wear, but doubt it. On the last lap already. I was close to the other Williams in the end. But a win's a win regardless. Checkered flag. Here we go.
Superb driving. That's the race win.
That's a spectacular victory then, and with it, the championship is secure. It's been a magnificent season, and they thoroughly deserve the cheers of the crowd here today. So, Anthony, what made the difference out there today?
I'd say it was down once again to good, consistent driving, nailing the corners, working to the track conditions, and perfecting the team's strategies. They got all of these things right today, and the results speak for themselves.
The faces on our top three look so incredibly happy as they make their way up to the podium. A much-deserved victory and a brilliant performance from them all. So, Anthony Davidson, who would you rank as your driver of the day?
Let's give it to Esteban Ocon. That was a commanding performance today. Very impressive indeed.
With that result, the sport's newest team can no longer be touched at the top of the table. What an incredible journey this has been for a team many had written off a short time ago. They are Formula One world champions. Meanwhile, good work from Aston Martin this weekend, who pushed themselves further up the order. And with that, we wrap up another weekend of motorsport. But with more races lined up, be sure to join us when we come back with more Formula One.
That was an exciting race from our perspective. How good does it feel? Your teammate is up on the podium today. It wasn't the clear. Appreciate your time.
Team's income is looking very robust right now. It's time for you to have a think about our profit margin and what areas of the operation might benefit from that money.
Right, I'm going to say thank you very much for watching. Please like, subscribe, share, hit that bell for notifications. And Brazil will be tomorrow. And until then, I'll see you all. Bye.